Are you a web designer using Elementor Pro as your designing tool for designing cool websites? Then this video is for you, because in this video, we'll give you a walkthrough of latest feature which they released in Elementor 3.17 beta. So some of the features are related to Ajax, which will help you build the widgets and the sections which will load without refreshing the page. So if you want to learn what are the latest features they added in 3.17 beta, stick to the video and let us know in the comments below what more you would like to learn in Elementor so we can create more valuable content for you. Without further ado, let's get into the screen to show you what are the latest features.
The first thing which this new update 3.17 beta has brought for us is the Ajax loop grid. Let's see what changes this loop grid has. Okay, so first of all, I'll click this plus sign from the screen, choose a flexbox container, and I'll be choosing this direction column. From the left side, click this plus sign and choose a loop grid. Drag it here like this. I'll create a template here. Click save and let's now create a template. Okay, so now what I'll be doing is I'll be adding a featured image first here. Then click this plus sign from the left side and add a post title. Okay, looks good. Then scroll down. And we will choose this post info here. Okay, delete the comments, the time, author, and we leave the date only. Looks good. We'll add some text first. Okay, let's add a text editor here. Okay, now I'll be adding a button. Let's just sort it out and give it some nice styling. Okay guys, so now I'm done with the styling. What I've done is made a very simple template. Let's click save so that the previous templates get into a loop. Let's see how it looks. Okay, so you guys can see how it looks. We have six different posts here. Okay, let's open structure so that it is easy for us to select. Okay, let's select the loop grid here. Okay, let's make the item per page 3. Okay, when we can make equal height. Okay, when we go to pagination here, you get option of numbers. Okay, here previously what you were getting was the option of page reloading. I'll show you how it looks when you reload the page. Let's click publish and preview how it looks. Okay, so when I click the second page, see what happens. The whole page gets loaded again. Okay, but now let's close it. What if I change the page reloader to Ajax? Okay, now let's see what the difference is. Let's click publish again and click preview here. Okay. See, when I click the second page, instead of loading the whole page, only the grid is changing. This is super easy, and now we won't be waiting for so much time to get the page loaded. I hope you like this update in this 3.17. Okay guys, so the second update which I really like the most is the new dating widget. Previously, in the old version, when let's add the dating widget so that you guys can learn more properly. Okay, what if I drag a dating widget here from the left side? Here you get two options. Either you can choose from 0 to 5 or 0 to 10. Now this version includes the new rating widget, which gives you more flexibility to customize your visual rating scales for product, content and more. Okay, so let's add a rating widget in the new version. Let's drag it from the left side. Okay, so this rating widget expands the option of rating scale that was previously available in the star rating widget. I mean to say that instead of choosing between a rating scale of 0 to 5 or 0 to 10, you can set a rating scale from 0 to any number that fits in your needs. Okay, like this, you can choose any number you want. You're not limited to only 0 to 5 or 0 to 10. Okay, so this is a great new update. Okay, so another great thing which this rating widget has is the icon. Okay, previously you have only these two options, font, awesome, and Unicode. But now you can choose your icon. You can upload the SVG file either, or you can choose from the icon library, whatever icon you want to be part of your rating widget. So this is a great update which I think will help us in future. So okay guys, so another great update which beta 3.17 has bought for us is the new accordion improvement. Okay, let's drag an accordion widget from the left side. Okay, what I'll do is I'll drag the accordion here on the screen. Previously, you're not getting option to add multiple templates in a single accordion, but now you can add, see there's a plus sign, you can add many different templates in this accordion widget. With its nested capabilities, it allows you to place widgets inside accordion item, giving you unlimited layout options. Okay, so this version 3.17 improves the SEO capability. Okay, so for example, I add this two column structure here. What I can do is, if I want to add another accordion in this accordion, let's see if we can. Oh yes, this is amazing. You can add anything you want in this accordion widget. So this is a great update which I think beta 3.17 has bought for us. Other than this, they have very small updates as well, which includes the AI history restore. The history of the AI generated material will be restored, the images will be restored, and you'll get a backup. This is amazing. And further, they have done things to update the performance, to improve the performance, which you guys can test it. I hope you like my tutorial. If you want more such videos, please don't forget to subscribe my channel, hit the like button, and don't forget to comment below so that you can get more such videos.